In case you like to play around with the trigger pull, so you want to make it more heavy or lighter, recommended is that you want to make it more heavy instead of lighter. I think lighter would make the reset of the mechanism a little bit too weak. But then, in any way, in case you can play around with it, maybe you find it lighter, nicer and still working. But yeah, anyways, if you want to do this, just remove the bottom screw at the buffer tube plate, the two screws at the lower, then you can lift the system up. It's recommended that you need it to remove the safety pin. So remove the grip and take everything out. So it's just a matter of pushing out the trigger pin. And then you can take out the trigger. So as you can see, this one looks different than this one. Can see that this one got a big piece at the top, what this will allow you to do is to place a regular spring in front. So this is really a long setup, so this will make your trigger really heavy, but you can also imagine that when you remove this spring, the AR trigger spring, it only used the power of this spring. Then it kind of makes it lighter again, but still this is a really big one. But you can use different spring lengths and thickness of the wire to kind of play around with what you like. So you can just now install it. And you notice that I forgot this piece, but it does matter, but not that much for now, just to play around with it. And then you can feel how it feels. And it's definitely more heavy. The idea why I was originally making it was, if it would be more heavy, then it will also return faster. So you can take your follow-up shots faster. But after some playing around, did it also really notice, and it's obvious of course, that your trigger finger will get more tired more easily, because it's more, yeah, it's not that much, but it's more heavy. Yeah, do think now in hindsight that just the normal trigger is okay. It's nice and light, it's smooth. But in case you do find that the trigger mechanism needs to be force reset more powerfully, then you can play around with this set and use a different spring, and maybe only use the front spring. But I do recommend that you install the grip again, even that it doesn't have this safety pin and all the spring that you need for that, the detent. Because this will give you the good grip that you can really measure around, like, okay, this is how it will feel. Otherwise, what I did in the beginning was just not install this grip and you hold this thing really different than normally, and it doesn't really tell you that much because you hold it differently and it's like, ah, okay, this is okay. But then, yeah, it's different. So it's make it so natural as possible and then just feel like it. But yeah, that's really it. I mean, you can, like I said before, you can remove the AR trigger spring and just go for only this setup as well. In case you find that this spring is getting weak or it's hard to get, but then again, you will be hard to get all the parts as well. But yeah, now again, it's really light in this case. But yeah, you can play around with it. That's kind of the idea, I guess, in the end. In case you want to fine tune the trigger, then now you can. You've got more options. Also, what I forgot to mention is, it's really useful to also install it back again with the upper. because then you feel the force. It's not that much, but you can some of the returning spring pressure will be lost because of the mechanism on top. And again, it's not that much, but it still is something. So yeah, that's why you just leave it all as one piece like this, the upper, and then you can just feel like, okay, it feels like this. And just trigger it a few times, kind of get the feel like, okay, and if you go really fast. Also with the TPX trigger, you want to pull it in one smooth motion. There's no wall or anything like that. There's no, you don't feel anything happening in the trigger. And you need to push it in a smooth way and kind of relatively fast. Otherwise, if you push it halfway, it starts leaking. Because that's how the trigger mechanism works inside. It's a pin that's activating with some valves inside. And if you pull it smooth, it will go fast past that point that it will leak and activate the firing mechanism. So and that's kind of the thing, you almost wanted to have two. You can pick this one up and the other one, because it's hard to remember exactly like this is better or is this worse. And that's kind of the thing, maybe you just need to play around with it actually by shooting. But yeah, it gives you the option to do it, but that's kind of the hard thing about it. You can use all those springs and use them in sequence, and it's like, yeah, this feels okay, but is it better? And I don't know anymore. That's kind of the crazy thing about it. But yeah, you can basically use this trigger if you only have it, just leave it like that. It's of course. This got more less material on the front than this one, but doesn't really affect the shooting that much. Yeah, what I do notice when it is more heavy is that it will return a little bit faster, or at least it's not faster, but it feels nicer. When you release the trigger, you feel more that it's, but it's not necessarily faster. And this is of course definitely lighter because you just use one spring in this case. But yeah, again, that's really a matter of taste. Even if we would tell you like this is the spring combination to use, then you use it and it's like that's garbage. It's really personal. But yeah.